Okay.
Okay, guys, so we are at a park. You can probably hear the music going. I want her to be in public spaces. Even though she's not noticing our surroundings, like, this is great. This is what we want to see. This is what I really want to encourage you guys to do. So think about this in your front yard, standing on the corner of White Oak, you know, just wherever it is. We'll figure out those places together. I'm happy to do that. So right now she's wearing a 4-foot leash and a front clipping harness that belongs to my dog, Reepy. It's definitely too big for her, and I think you saw it, but I need her to have one of these to be able to get this work in right. So let's put our fundamentals in place. So what I do with every dog when I get them into a public display, hey, remember, trainers have to take a breath too, always take a breath. Whenever I get them into a public place, I like to acclimate them because, you know, I had a lot of coffee this morning. I get a little overwhelmed too. So I really want to just kind of, with that presence of mind, think about her. We know how she reacts to things. Yes, good girl. That was great. A shake off. That's what we want, okay? We want that shake off and then that check in. So essentially, what you're going to do is get her acclimated to the space. Walk her back and forth. Let her just burn that energy off, just like I was talking about before. Oh. Are we good?
Mm-hmm. All right,
cool. Yeah, because like for a second ago, we were at a park, or we were driving by a playground next to like an elementary school, and she started barking at the kids that were 25 feet away playing. So when my dogs play, she gets a little about it. She doesn't know how to control that energy. So that's why when you're working with a dog, you want to take her to a patio, somewhere like that. She needs to be doing this stuff. Don't pull her, don't yank her along. That's why, hey, luring works great. Come on. And now the big thing is you have to really learn to manage your expectations with this kind of stuff, because it's all about motivation. Oh, weird. It's all about motivation with dogs and finding their motivation. She doesn't have a lot of motivation to move right now for whatever reason. So I can't force her. So let's just see what we can get when we go this way. Come on. Nope. I don't know how that car started. There's nobody in there.
It's an automatic start.
Perfect time. Ah. So look how I checked her immediately. We're going to detour her. So that's why it's a little big. Well, that's why I was worried about it being a little big. Your dog's name is Steven?
So this is too big. That's so funny.
All right. So see, that's probably the worst that can happen. So that's why we need it to be secure. It has to be. Nope. Come on. So we're just going to walk her back and forth right now. Keep it up. Good. So if you don't have a harness that's tight and snug on her, it's just not, you're not going to get the results. Good. Come on. Good. He said his dog's name is Steven, right? That's amazing. All right, come on. Let's go. She's a tough cookie. Let's go. Come on. So also something I didn't touch on. So part of acclimation is priming. And the reason why we had a failure, the harness. It's not her, it's not me, it's the harness. It's gotta be stuck.
Here. The harness.
We wanna find little moments in public, simple stuff. Not gonna force her, and we're gonna take what she gives us. Redirections. Simple stuff like that. I don't care if she's trying to smell brick, if she's trying to smell grass. We can redirect her in public. That's a victory. Gotta start somewhere. Come on. See? Start to communicate with her a little better this way. We're not super worried about loose leash walking. We're just worried about exposure.
Okay, master.
Okay, good. All right, we're gonna take even more space now. So she's not ready for, so in moments like this, you wanna always find a teaching moment. It's your dog peed right here. So see how that reaction time, she's struggling with that? When you know she's doing well, is when you can shorten that reaction time. And it's a lot for her. Notice she's not snatching treats. Notice she's not giving love. I don't know. You know, you just get that vibe. She's a little overwhelmed. So we have to take spaces like this, this little park off of Hammerly, is that where we're at? Hammerly, Bingle, somewhere like that. And not go to a big one. Don't go to Memorial right now. There's no need. Come on, come here. You just have to find little moments like that, like now. So this is what I mean by taking what she's giving us. I would love to have interacted with more dogs, been able to do that. But what she's offering is pulling towards that. That's not okay. I don't do that. I'm not okay with that. And little moments like this are gonna help you get to where you want to get. So once she starts doing this more reliably, just like this, treats are fine for her. I don't train every dog with treats, but treats are fine for her because it's what's gonna get her motivated, aside from just like, oh my gosh, the music. Come on. Good, that was great. Guys, rewind the YouTube video, watch how she cut this way and then whip back that way. Little stuff like that. You know, not everybody can see it. So here's another one. Here's another chance. So we don't pull. Hey. Look, so she's standing her ground. She doesn't play around. Come on. We need to teach her that right there. Also need to touch on is recall. Probably gonna bring her here tomorrow to work on that. Schwartz Park, that's where we're at. And then I wait for eye contact. This is how you train eye contact. Yes. Okay, let's go. We're gonna start moseying back here. I'm gonna walk around the park here. Come on. Hey, what's up, y'all? What's up, man? Huh? Getting this little dog trained up. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that.
Hello.
She gets a little intense around people. She. So I'm like. Let's go to a calm spot.
Right.
Let's just chill. Did right. You ask what kind of dog?
I'm sorry? Yes.
No, no, she's a Cocker Spaniel.
Cocker Spaniel.
Cocker Spaniel. Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, she's a cool dog. She's really sweet. Y'all have a good practice, fellas.
Thanks.
Good girl. That's what we need right there, honey.
That's what we need.
That's what we need. That's what we need.
That's what we need. Look, breadcrumbs.
Good.
We're at 9 minutes.
All right, we're almost done here, guys. We try to leave them about 7 to 10. And that moment around the basketball court is the moment we were looking for. So look at the contrast between the two different scenarios there. It's great to see. So we're gonna do a little review and end here. So what's important for your dog, this Ruby? Harness, rough wear harness. Probably a small, extra small. I don't know what size that one is that Erica's holding, but eye contact in public.
Extra, this is a small.
So she's gonna need an extra small, okay? So priming, walking back and forth, just like I showed you in that loose leash video, okay? the other day, walking back and forth. Simple, simple, simple contest. My training bubble, she needs to be in that. See, boom, that's what you need, okay? And then, not forcing her along, looking for your reaction time. She's smelling a wall. Take a breath, find your moment. Don't repeat her name. See, right there. And you can spend 5-10 minutes out there. And that's what you're gonna need to do. So don't overwhelm yourself. Take what she gives you. Thank you guys, bye-bye.